Welcome to our What's New video for Proxmox Virtual Environment 8.2. This video is going to show the highlights in this new release. We support automated and unattended installation of Proxmox VE. Our tool enables you to modify the default ISO. The resulting automated installation ISO retrieves all necessary settings from an answer file. This answer file can be provided in three ways. It can be directly embedded in the ISO, can be placed on a separate USB drive, or can be accessed over the network. Automated installation is useful in various scenarios, such as deploying large-scale infrastructure, automating the setup process, and ensuring consistent configurations across multiple systems. Here, I'm going to show you how the new import wizard for VMware ESXi virtual machines works. First, we're going to establish the connection to the VMware ESXi host. To do this, we mount the host as a new Proxmox storage. If we now go to the demo ESXi storage, we can see all the VMware virtual machines that we can import. We also have a more detailed tutorial on the import wizard on our channel, where we demonstrate importing a Windows 2022 server VM from ESXi. The modernized Proxmox VE firewall implementation is based on NFTables. The new implementation is written in Rust and intended to replace our current firewall based on IPTables in future Proxmox VE versions. The NFTables firewall is for now provided as an experimental feature to gather feedback from our community. It is a per-host firewall setting. Until its feature set is on par with the current implementation, the NFTables firewall still needs to be enabled manually. LXC device pass-through enables you to configure host device pass-through for containers directly within the user interface. Backup jobs come with new advanced settings, including performance settings and bandwidth limits. We've added support for custom ACME-enabled certificate authorities with optional authentication via external account binding. This version brings small but impactful UI changes in several areas. On the Notes field, the double-click editing option has been disabled. This now allows you to easily select and copy text without accidentally opening the editor. But naturally, you can enable the old behavior as well. On edit screens, the reset button is on a new position now, with the idea of reducing the risk of accidental clicks. Proxmox Virtual Environment 8.2 is based on the latest Debian 12.5 codenamed Bookworm, combined with leading open source technologies for virtual environments. This includes a modern Linux kernel 6.8, Ceph 18.2, Kemu 8.1, and OpenZFS 2.2. We encourage you to explore the new features, and please let us know your feedback to help us further refine and improve Proxmox Virtual Environment. That's it. Thank you for watching.